Hello, my name is Peter West with West Networks, and today we are going to try an experiment. I have a ReadyNAS 214. This is an ARM, quad-core ARM processor with 2 gigs of RAM, dual gigabit Ethernet ports, and supports 4 hard drives, a total capacity of 40 terabytes of storage. And I really want to play around with Hyper-V and virtualization, and so I want to play around with the ReadyNAS 424. It has 2 gigabit Ethernet ports. Both of these support link aggregation with a Netgear switch. This is expandable. The 424 is expandable to 90 terabytes, and it's powered by an Intel Atom processor, so a much more powerful processor that allows for more throughput, higher performance, and is really a business class network attached storage device. But the problem that I have, and I'm wondering a lot of people might have, is what happens when I take the hard drives out of the 214 and plug it into the 424, and am I gonna lose all my data? So I have my ReadyNAS storage device powered on, connected to my 214. I have my 10.9 terabyte array with 4 4-terabyte drives, and I'm using about 2.5 maybe terabytes, 2.75 terabytes of actual used storage here. And so what we're gonna do is take the hard drives out of this one, plug them into this one, and see if it just is a seamless migration or if I just lost all of my data. And that's what we're gonna do. So I'm gonna go and shut down my 214. And the 424 is expandable using expansion modules for SAS expanders and supports a total of 90 terabytes of storage, which is absolutely phenomenal in my opinion for such a low profile, small business a network storage device. ReadyNAS also supports ReadyNAS replication. So if I really wanted to, I could put 4 drives in here, replicate it, and then this becomes my new master. This is my kind of like slave device or replication device. But I don't want to do that. I want to see what happens when I take the drive out. And this is really more for what if the device fails, or what if I had some environmental issue, maybe a power supply failure or network card failure due to a lightning strike or something. And I want to make sure that, you know, I can upgrade without any loss of data or functionality. Anytime you're transitioning a RAID array, you want to make sure the drives align. So you only want to take these out one at a time. So I'm going to take out drive one, plug it in, take out drive two, plug it in, got drive three, plug it in. Drive four, plug it in. Okay, now I'm just gonna move my 90 watt power adapter because they're the same. I'm gonna move my Ethernet cable. Let's see what happens. Okay, so the system is booted up. And the funny, so I just went to readycloud.netgear.com, signed in, and it's already connected. So it must be that the operating system runs on its own environment, but the configuration is actually stored in the hard drives that I've installed, because I now have in my manage, I have my ReadyNAS 424, shows it's healthy. I have my serial number. I show my data drive of 9.19 terabytes free. I can click on home. I can browse my documents and see my home folders there. And there's my files. So the answer to the question is, can I take the hard drives out of a ReadyNAS 214 and upgrade to a 424? The answer is yes, just take them out and put them in. What I'll probably do now is, it actually says my ReadyNAS name is ReadyNAS 214, so I'll probably rename it 424, but actually kept the same name and everything. It says ReadyNAS 214, but when I go to manage, it shows it as a ReadyNAS 424, and even my shared folders are still active. The Ready Cloud and all those settings stayed synchronized. So the answer is yes, it works.